and a warm welcome to our chief guest, Ms. Anjali Karyappa, our principal, Ms. Farida, Fra's vice principal, Ms. Shweta Kotapalli, heads of school, coordinators, parents, teachers, and my dear friends.
Founded in 2008, Indus International School Hyderabad is celebrating its annual school day today. There are loads of fun, entertainment, and message planned for this evening. Hope you are ready to celebrate and reflect on our journey this far. We're delighted to share this experience with you, and by the end of this evening, hope to have you feel pride of what we did and inspirations to reach new heights in the future.
Over the years, we have taken impressive strides in growing our school. The people at Indus are its true strength. We're all part of Indus ecosystem. Our school is the tree and we are its leaves, flowers, branches, roots and teachers that live in it. This tree keeps getting stronger with the values of love, respect, empathy and discipline. We are dedicated eagles who will continue to fly high from its branches to the sky with innovation progress under our wings.
I'd like to request everyone to keep their phones on silent mode and refrain from coming to the front and taking pictures, as we have photographers and videographers who will do the needful.
Wise Gautam Buddha said that thousands of candles can be lit by a single candle. Happiness never decreases when shared. We share this happy moment by lighting these lamps. I would request our chief guest, Ms. Anjali Karyappa, Ms. Farida Fraz, Ms. Shweta Kotapalli, Ms. Shweta Jolly, and Ms. Preeti Ramesh to please come forward and light the lamp. Our principal, Ms. Farida Fraz, has been associated with Indus for over 7 years. She has served in the field of education for more than 11 years with the sole aim of transforming education. I now request our principal, Ms. Farida, to please say a few words.
Ms. Anjali, our PAC members, parents, and teachers, it is my pleasure, privilege, and honor to welcome you to this evening of celebration of life through a series of performances. Indus believes in the philosophy of whole education, which is about unlocking human potential, potential of our students, our eagles. The PAC has strongly cemented our bond with the parents. I thank you for believing in us. This evening is a tribute to all parents whose superstars have put in their heart, soul, and mind to take away your breath with their exemplar performances. Our theme for this year's Indus Day is adaptability, which also resonates with our school motto, In Omnia Paratus, prepared for all challenges. The theme adaptability has been deliberately chosen. It took a pandemic for us to realize that we're all born with the seeds of growth mindset and adaptability. All it requires is nurturing Whatever age we are, we can adapt to any given situation if we have an open mind. Our CEO, Lieutenant General Arjun Ray, often reiterates the point that as educators, we must not only teach the subject, but also teach the child. He never fails to point out that the purpose of education is to make our students future ready. Towards this, if I'm asked to advise our young students to pick one skill that'll help them to be future ready and to be successful in their careers and also in their life, that would be adaptability. And the reason is that the world today is not the world we're going to be living in the next 5 years, 10 years, or 15 years from now. As General always says, we live in a VUCA world. It's volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous. The world is changing. Yesterday's learning is obsolete today. New opportunities are knocking at the doorstep, for which we must be open to innovative ideas. Now, while adaptability is a powerful skill, it is also a word that is thrown around a lot, a skill that is oversighted, without true understanding of what it really means. Adaptability is more than being flexible. It's about being comfortable in the uncomfortable. The times when you feel the most uncomfortable are the times when you're challenged to make a shift towards progress. Speaking of taking steps towards progress and the better, at Indus, we not only focus on academics, but also on service through CAS. In our efforts towards making the world a better place, this year, the school has undertaken the following service projects. Reviving the Areca Leaf Project for manufacturing plates and program. We'll be serving a nutritious meal every day to Anganwadi schools in the surrounding villages starting January 2023. Organic farm on school campus. An acre of land has been identified for organic farming within the campus. Vegetables will be grown organically to be used for the midday meal program. A lake revival project. Our students have identified a lake in the Kondikal village for adoption. Students will maintain this lake by conducting regular cleanup drives. Another area where we are becoming a better version of ourselves is sports. Sports is not just a physical activity, but an integrated approach for learning and a gateway to relieve stress. Our students have been soaring high at this front as well. I will need some claps here. Topil Bense Biju of grade 11 has participated in the rifle shooting national championship in Delhi in the under 16 category rifle shooting and nationals held in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala on 23rd of November. Kunduru Ishanvi Reddy of grade 9 participated and won the first position in the 13th South Zone Shotgun Championship. And coming to the little ones, Amaya Agarwal of grade 2 secured first place in under 7 Ekagra All India below 2005 rated International Grandmaster Chess Tournament. Anay Agarwal of grade 2 secured 8th position in Ekagra under 7 All India below 1605 rated International Chess Tournament held in Hyderabad. Agam Jain of grade 8 secured the first position in the under 14 category 100 meters race in the Hyderabad District Meet and participated in the Telangana State Meet. I would also like to take this opportunity to talk about the collaborative learning model at Indus. As part of the innovative culture, encouraged by General Ray, Indus has introduced one-of-a-kind humanoid robot called Eagle 5. The robot has been introduced as part of the indigenously designed collaborative learning model, which facilitates man-machine learning. The collaborative learning model allows the human teacher more time to focus on the child, provide individual support, and personalized learning. While the robot takes over all the repetitive tasks of the teacher, such as delivering content, clarifying misconceptions, and conducting automated assessments. This now enables the teacher to teach the child and not the subject alone. The advantages of the collaborative learning model are many: improved academic rigor, enhancement of the effectiveness of teaching and learning, optimizing teacher workload. Well, while I take pride in all of our achievements, it is also a moment to express my gratitude to all of you for supporting us at every step. We celebrate our education world ranking to number 4 in India and number 1 in Telangana for the last 4 consecutive years. IISH is an incredible combination of vision, culture, and talent. And what makes us outliers are the people we are associated with: our parents, students, teachers, and every individual who come together to become a part of IISH. With this, let us begin this evening of astounding amazement as our youngest eagles are all set to win our hearts, not just with their cuteness, but with all the dedication and hard work that they've put in the last few days. So ladies and gentlemen, we need a round of applause for our young eagles even before we begin. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Be inspired by your words. They say the job of the feet is to walk, but their hobby is peep to a great one. We'll now present the invocation dance, Mahaganpatim Mansa, which is set in a traditional Indian dance form Kuchipudi and is an ode to Lord Ganesha, the remover of all obstacles.
Kuchipudi is an Indian classical dance originating in Andhra Pradesh, but popular all over South India. According to legend, often named Siddhendra Yogi founded the Kuchipudi dance drama tradition. The dance drama tradition is accompanied by Carnatic music. The singer is accompanied by mridangam, violin, flute, and the tambura.
Padanam.
Salvation Song, Where the Mind is Without Fear, is a constant reminder of the need to make education the means of light in an equitable world. This is the song that inspires us to do all our duties, from the smallest to the biggest challenges, so that we can be positive force in the world we live in. I'd like to call upon Asta Kinney and Ananya Chaudhary to please come forth and sing the invocation song. Storyteller. She has good experience in language and life skills training with corporate houses, educators, and hospitality industry. We are delighted to have you here, ma'am. I now call upon our chief guest, Ms. Anjali Kadiappa, to please share her thoughts.
Thank you, Shaunak, for that nice introduction. A very good evening to all of you. A very good evening, Ms. Farida, Mr. Anand, Ms. Shweta, and all the dear teachers at Indus, and parents and dear children. I'm absolutely delighted to be here, and especially so after I heard what the theme is, which is adaptability. Being from the space of social emotional learning, I think adaptability is the end goal for all social and emotional skills. So it's wonderful and beautiful to see children as young as 5 to 7 year olds to be working on the theme of adaptability. So keeping with the theme, I thought maybe what I could best do was share a few reflection questions for all of us to think about as parents as well as educators. So I was wondering, what are some of the skills that our children truly need? Right, as a society, we don't shy away from making financial plans for our children. We make plans for their physical education. We make plans for their nutrition. We make plans for skill building, for hobbies. But how often do we all have a plan for social and emotional skills? Very often we don't, right? But yet it is the plate on which all other learning happens. And as Ms. Farida was mentioning, in the VUCA world, our children are going to be stepping into a world which is going to be so different from ours. And our children will not have the cushion of old generation wisdom. And I think COVID has shown us that. So they don't have old generation wisdom. So what do they depend on? Because they are going to be facing problems that we have never experienced before. So they're going to go to peer wisdom. And how do they deal with peer wisdom if they don't have a sense of self? So one of the most important things for children of the future would probably be being able to handle multiple perspectives. And how do you handle multiple perspectives without a sense of self? So one of the important skills our children in the future will be understanding, as having a sense of self, who are they, what is important to them, and what are the values that they stand for. Because with these skills, when they're bombarded with different perspectives, they will be able to understand what they truly want, sieve through all the perspectives that they're getting, have the self-awareness to choose what they want and who they want to be. So the first reflective question as parents and as educators that I'd like to share with you all is, how many opportunities are we making for our children to get multiple perspectives? Are we really giving them the experiences? So maybe we should think about it. Ideally, 20-year-olds today shouldn't be wondering about what do I do in life, because they should have figured it out by the time they're 20, isn't it? So identifying our children's strengths and giving them opportunities and experiences would be a very important skill as educators as well as parents, is something that we can give our children. Another skill that would be very important for children in the future would be curiosity. Curiosity is not something we need to teach our children, right? Because children already have it. But very often as adults in the world, we kind of stifle curiosity. But it's curiosity is what children need, because curiosity helps you discover things. It helps you to learn and unlearn things. It helps you to innovate. It helps you to come up with new ideas. It helps you to problem solve. So what are the opportunities we are giving our children to continue to remain curious and continue to enjoy and loving learning? So that's another skill, I think, which would be so important for children in the future. So the third thing is, I'd just like to ask, how many of us have a plan to spend quiet time with our children? Is that included in our schedule? Do we have quiet time for our children? Do we have undisturbed time to really get to know who they are? Do our children have enough downtime or quiet time to discover what they like and what they don't like? Or are they running with what the society tells them they should like or they shouldn't like? Because the quiet time is where your child builds self-soothing skills. And self-soothing skills is one of the most important human skills, because from the space of self-soothing is where you build emotional regulation skills. There's so much of talk today about emotional wellness. There's so much of talk about mental health, which is very important. But it often stops at emotional awareness, that it's okay to feel. It's okay to feel happy, scared, angry. It's okay to cry. But emotional wellness goes beyond that, because emotional awareness is only the plate. So it's from that plate that children also need emotional regulation skills. From that space, they also need emotional resilience skills. It's once I know to regulate myself, how do I stay with the problem, even if I have a difficult emotion. And from that space comes emotional agility. And it is in the space of emotional agility that adaptability is born. And it's when we have the skills of adaptability that change and transformation happens. And that's where our children will truly thrive. So do we have enough quiet time for our children? Because time is love. What our children need is time from all of us. So are we spending enough time being with our children rather than doing things? Because it's in the being that we build the deepest relationship with our child. So here's to making time to enable all these skills, to enable emotional well-being, to enable adaptability, to enable all the skills that children need to thrive in the future. So looking forward to the evening, and I hope all of us as educators and parents make the time, effort, and the quiet space for our children to build skills that will really help them thrive in the future. Thank you very much, and really looking forward to the lovely evening and discovering how children have worked with this theme.
Famous Michael Jackson said that every living thing has a rhythm. Do you feel your music? Here's an instrumental by our EYP students to charge your soul. performance. Movies make you famous. Television makes you rich. But theater makes you good. Here's a very important message on adaptability from our EYP students in the form of drama. The title of our drama is, In the Waves of Change, We Find Our Direction. As Paul Luther said, the most successful people are the ones who accept and adapt a constant change. And this requires flexibility and humility. This is the story about growing water pollution, dying rivers, ignorance towards garbage management, adaptability, fear towards uncertainty, and anxiety towards change. But in heart, the story is about what one does in fear, how to overcome the fear, and being courageous to work the change.
During the we learned that the growing water pollution is making the living conditions poor for the fish. When faced with adversity, some of the fish are scared to change and some are not flexible towards any solution given to them and some are open-minded trying to find different solutions. Do all the fish come together or they break into different groups? Let's find out if anything changes or if nothing changes.
Don't eat the other fish.
Our lunch is yummy.
Off you go. Have you all done your math homework?
The sums were very tough.
I couldn't do it either. We ate the homework yummy.
But I completed it
all the work. Math homework and English homework.
Oh, Goldie, we had two homeworks.
Of course you had two homeworks.
I forgot.
Or did you eat the homework?
No.
Those are very naughty sharks. Welcome to our home.
I am sure you have guessed where we live.
This beautiful river is our home. We grew up on the banks of this river.
And I can say proudly that the water of this river is fresh and sweet.
river is the house to lots of fishes and other marine life. People from surrounding town come to take a boat ride and enjoy the river.
Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
Look at the ball of fire, eaten by the water.
It's not a ball of fire, it's the sun setting.
Hey, why are you dirtying our home?
If I dirty your house, how will you feel?
Before all these people came here, the fish lived happily in the river. As the river water was clean, the fish were able to breathe and enjoy themselves in this clean water. But slowly, as the number of tourists increased, the river started to become dirty. A new factory opened nearby, and all the factory waste started to get pumped into this beautiful river.
Are you coming to school, Goldie?
No, I can't.
She is unwell.
The dirty water in the nest all falls in.
The sharks are also not well.
Let's go to school. Bye.
The meeting.
My dear fish friends, things are very fishy in the river. The river water is becoming polluted day by day, and we have come here to discuss what we can do about it.
All the plastic in the river is choking us up.
Our children are falling sick.
As a doctor, I would say patients have increased in the past 2 months.
We should eat all the people who are dirtying our house.
Kill them, eat them, chew them, kill them.
Everybody quiet, quiet everybody. We must find a solution without harming anyone.
What is the solution?
Should we stop breathing?
How do we stop people dirtying our homes?
Actually, we must prepare ourselves.
Prepare for what?
Probably we can change our home.
You mean to say run away from our homes?
No! Never!
Is that the only solution left?
Yes, if it goes on like this, one day you will all fall sick and die.
But what you'd ask us to do is impossible.
We will not go anywhere.
No, never.
The fish could find no solution, so they all returned to their homes.
Some months passed by like this, but the river became dirtier and dirtier.
Bye.
most of the fish were falling sick and dying.
The meeting was called again.
Everyone was very worried.
Thank you for coming, fish. The matter has become more serious now.
My mama died because of plastic getting stuck in her tummy.
I couldn't help her too. The number of patients have doubled and tripled.
I am sorry to hear about your loss.
It's okay. It's the older or the younger ones who are dying.
We can't breathe. The water is so dirty that we can't even see properly.
We must do something about it.
The wise turtle heard everything.
Oh, wise turtle, please tell me what were you saying in the day in meeting?
There is a stream full of fresh water. We all can move there and live.
You're asking us to move our houses?
I'm asking you to save your life.
How do you know about this stream and where is it?
We should swim all the way up to find the sweet water.
And I know about the stream because my ancestors came from there.
But why?
Because like us, they have moved here in search of sweet water.
How can we trust you?
What if there is no sweet water stream?
We can swim upstream, come back and tell you.
You guys are taking a lot of risks.
Someone must take risk for our community.
All the best!
All the best!
All the best!
So it was decided that both the rainbow fish would swim upstream.
The wise turtle showed them the way and everyone came to say goodbye.
A little before upstream, there was a small fisherman colony. Their lives were dependent on fishing.
Early morning, they would leave on their boats and come back with lots of catch.
Thank you.
The fishermen had laid their fishing net near the upstream. Little did the friends swimming know about the danger that lay ahead.
Have you all fixed your net?
Yeah, I repaired it.
Then throw it.
Your friend,
I am trapped in the net. Please help me. Please help me. Please help me.
I caught it. I caught the fish.
Looks like a good catch.
Try to wiggle off.
I can't. Promise me to swim upstream. Look out.
I promise you, my dear friend, I promise.
Rainbow Fish kept his promise to his friend and swam upstream and found Sweet Water Lake.
While the fishermen were happy with their catch,
fishermen's livelihood was dependent on the number of fish they caught every day. Rainbow Fish returned to the river.
Everyone was waiting for the brave friends to return.
Rainbow Fish told everyone present about what happened.
That is why I said before we should be here.
Wait, did you find a sweet water lake?
Yes, sir, I did.
And is it clean water?
Yes, sir. We have lot of places for us.
Listen. There's an oil spill.
What?
It's becoming bigger and bigger.
Where?
On our water, and it's spreading.
That means we are all going to die.
What can we do in this emergency?
Looks like we all have to leave this place.
Is there any other solution apart from leaving our homes?
But our dear friend died
while swimming upstream.
So you want to die here?
Choose where you want to die.
My whole family is here.
I have an idea.
We should all swim upstream.
Swim upstream! Swim upstream! Swim upstream!
I'm not going to move. This is my home. And I'm
never going to leave it.
Only lion, only lion, only lion.
Silence, silence everybody. Those of you who are scared to swim can stay. But we should plan our move fast.
I have some rainbow fish to get the weather report.
The weather department has issued a warning. There will be a lot of disturbance.
That means no fishermen.
That means we have 2 days window to swim upstream.
I would like to swim with our children.
Do you have any idea how difficult it is to swim in the rain?
I was born in this river. I grew up here.
Yes, she grew up in this.
Shh! That place is new. Everything will be unfamiliar.
It's okay to be scared, my friend, but we will always be with you. Let's do it together.
Change of any kind will make us unsure and frightened.
But how we adapt to this change is the key.
Let's be courageous and face our fears.
Decided that all the fish would swim upstream into 2 batches for the next 2 days.
Supported by good swimmers.
And the second batch was all the remaining fish. All the fish tried to swim together, motivating the other. All the fish swam upstream without any casualty.
The water is clean. We have lots of space to live.
It is beautiful.
Even though I'm so tired of this journey, I must say it was worth it.
This happened together.
We all took the chance.
We said yes to the change.
All the fish were very happy being in the new place.
Change for the good is a welcome change.
We are a small part of this wonderful planet Earth. Heal the water, heal the land, so that we can all live happily ever after.
Oh Maria Pitache, oh Maria Pitache, oh Maria Pitache, hey, oh Maria Pitache, hey, oh Maria Pitache, oh Maria Pitache, oh Maria Pitache, hey, oh Maria Pitache, hey, oh, Barra da Tama, me luzi, estreti compri. Barra da Tama, me luzi, estreti compri. Alec na entrada me luzi, triste na sair. Alec na entrada me luzi, triste na sair. Hey! Por Por amor da faixa me luzi, eu fico soldado. Por amor da faixa me luzi, eu fico soldado. Fazer a sentinela me luzi, levar chicotada. Fazer a sentinela me luzi, levar chicotada. Oh Maria Pitache, 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 oh Maria Pitache.
Anda Maria, dança!
Rapariga feia me luzi, não se pode nascer. Rapariga feia me luzi, não se pode nascer. Como a pera verde me luzi, não se pode comer. Como a pera verde me luzi, não se pode comer. Chão. Ai, luzi, luzi, me luzi, não cuspi no chão. Cuspir no meu peito, me luzi, regai coração. Cuspir no meu peito, me luzi, regai coração. Ai, Maria Pitache, oh 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 Maria Pitache.
I now request our Vice Principal, Ms. Shweta Kotipalli, to please propose the vote of thanks.
Good evening to the chief guest, Ms. Anjali, parents, teachers, and my dear students. I do hope you have enjoyed the evening and the performances put up by our little ones. It is indeed my pleasure to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion on behalf of the entire Indus fraternity. Let me start by expressing my sincere gratitude to our chief guest, Ms. Anjali Karyappa, who has spared the time from her busy schedule to grace this occasion. We have had an opportunity today to hear your thoughts, and they are well aligned to the vision of the school. Be thankful for what you have, you'll end up having more. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you'll never ever have. The events this evening have been a spectacular display of talent by our budding rock stars. I would like to extend a special thanks to them for the show, but it was not only talent, but also resilience, discipline, and collaboration that they have unearthed. You would agree with me that they made this event very enjoyable. Please give a huge round of applause to our youngest eagles here. An event like this cannot happen on its own. In this institution, we are fortunate to have a set of proactive, committed, and dedicated staff members who have spearheaded this such events. Thank you, teachers. A special mention to our respected principal, Ms. Farida Fraz, for being the catalyst that stimulates us to do our best. I would like to thank our specialist team who are the architects behind the whole program, Mr. Pradeep, Ms. Shamishta Sarkar and Ms. Riparna for the beautiful artwork. Ms. Geeta and Ms. Vishnu Vandana for the fluid dance performances. Ms. Shweta Vij for drama. Mr. Bijumani, Mr. Sareen, and Mr. Prasanna Kumar for music. Ms. Bharati Lakhani for preparing the MCs. Ms. Sangeeta for the invite. Our leadership team, Ms. Shweta Jolly and Ms. Preeti, for continuously encouraging and guiding the students to do their best. Ms. Pushpita Balkrishnan, our activities coordinator and the mastermind behind this whole event. Her planning and coordination has ensured that the event was smooth and flawless. Her energy has been unbeatable, and this has made sure that the whole event was fun and lively. Thank you, Ms. Pushpita. Thank you, Mr. Mahesh, for all the financial support. Thank you, Wing Commander Mr. Anand and his admin team for their relentless and 24/7 efforts in making show a success. I would also like to thank our ICT team, Mr. Shravan and Mr. Prem, Mr. Amjad and team for the splendid work on the stage, Mr. Avinash and team for the sound and light. And also our support staff, without who all this would not have happened. Thank you so much. Last but not the least, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to all the parents who made it here today to encourage and appreciate the performance by our younger ones here. Another huge round of applause to these kids. Thank you, everyone.
for being a part of this evening and always encouraging us. Most importantly, thank you to all my VYP friends.
Let's start with reception and PP1 parents. I request only reception and PP1 parents to please go inside and pick your child. Thank you so much. Followed by the other grades, I'll be announcing. Thanks so much for your cooperation.